Hello class, I hope you all are safe and following all the safety rules. Am I right? Good. So students, in today's class we are going to discuss a very important time period that had played a very significant role in the development of human civilization, and that is the Stone Age. Well, I know you must be thinking, what is the reason behind this weird name and why is it so important? But you'll get all your answers gradually as we discuss the topic. Okay? Before proceeding further, let me just recall you what I have taught in the last class. Well, the topics were evolution, hominids, and the types of hominids. The types were Homo habilis, Homo erectus, and Homo sapiens. And there were two more topics, the Neanderthals and the Cro-Magnons. So I suggest you to watch that video before proceeding further. Okay? So students, in Stone Age, the tools were made of stones mostly, and that is how it got its name. Okay, the name the Stone Age is due to this reason. The tools were made of stone only. Okay, now this age has some specific features. These features are the discovery of fire, the invention of wheel and pottery, and the beginning of agriculture. Okay, there are four parts of this age, the Stone Age. First one is the Old Stone Age, that is the Paleolithic Age. The second one is the Middle Stone Age, that is Mesolithic Age. Third one is the New Stone Age, Neolithic Age. Or the fourth one is the Copper Stone Age, that is the Chalcolithic Age. Okay, we are going to discuss them one by one. Okay, so first of all, let me discuss the first one, the Old Stone Age. Or the Paleolithic Age. The first one is the Paleolithic Age. Well, as you can see, the time period for this age was from 50,000 BCE to 10,000 BCE. That means this was the longest stone age. Okay, so Paleolithic age was the longest stone age. It lasted for 40 years. Now, in this age, the tools were made of stones that were chipped and shaped. That is why they were very heavy and blunt. Okay, so the tools were very heavy and blunt. Okay, now they used these tools for cutting the trees, digging up the roots, and for the hunting of animals. Okay, now in this age, the humans were still hunter-gatherers. They were keep hunting and collecting the food. Okay, they were living in the caves or on the trees to protect themselves from wild animals or from heat or cold. So here I'm going to write where they were living. They were living in caves, or on trees. Okay, also in this age, the human was wearing barks of trees, leaves, and animal skin as their clothes. Okay, so the human used to wear the barks of trees, leaves, and animal skins. As their clothes. Okay? Now I am going to discuss a very, very important discovery of this age, and that is the discovery of fire. Okay, the discovery of fire. I'm going to write it here. Okay. Now we are going to discuss the discovery of fire. Okay, see, the early humans were very intelligent and also they were keen learners. They observed that the lightning produced fire, and hence it is believed that they rubbed two stones together to produce a spark that helped them in lighting a fire. Okay, so the beginning of fire was done by rubbing two stones together. Okay, now this invention has played a very significant role in the life of human, because it lit up their caves, it kept them warm in during winters, and also it kept themselves safe from wild animals. Okay. Another very important thing done in Paleolithic age was that the human has started making jewelries of animal bones and horns or of stones. Okay. Now let's move to the second age, that is the Middle Stone Age or the Mesolithic age. Okay, so let's discuss it here. The second one is I'm going to write down the original name, that is Mesolithic age. Okay, so this age starts from 10,000 BCE to 8,000 BCE. Okay, and as you can see, this this comes in between these two ages. Okay, the Old Stone Age and the New Stone Age. So basically, this is nothing but the transition period from Old Stone Age to the New Stone Age. Okay, so here I am going to write, this is a transition period from Old Stone Age to New Stone Age. Okay. Now, in this age, the tools became much lighter. Okay, and were known as mesoliths. Okay. Now, I'm going to tell you that they were still hunter gatherers. They were still living in caves, but one thing they started learning, that was to build small houses. That means they were still hunter gatherers. They were still hunter gatherers. They were still living in caves. But the only thing that was new was started building houses. Only some of them has started building small mud houses. Okay. So there's nothing so significant done in this Mesolithic age or the Middle Stone age. Okay. So now I'm moving on to the Neolithic age. Okay. So, the New Stone Age or the Neolithic Age. Okay, as you can see, this age starts from 8000 BCE to 4000 BCE. That is, for 4000 years it lasted. Okay, now this age is really important. Mark my words, this age is really important because it gave us so many significant things that played a very important role in the development of human civilization. I'll tell you how. So let's start. First of all, in new stone age the human have started making polished stone weapons. Okay, the humans have started making polished stone weapons or tools. You can use whatever you want. Okay, so the human have started making polished stone weapons or tools. The second thing is they have also learned to make some new weapons such as bows and arrows. Learn to make some new weapons example bows and arrows. Okay, now in this age the human have started building small houses, very small mud houses. Okay, I'll tell you the reason why they have started building houses here in this age. These houses had thatched roofs. Okay, now I'm not going to erase it. I'm just going to tell you some very important discoveries done in Neolithic age. The first one is the beginning of agriculture. This one is really very important. Here it comes, the beginning of agriculture. I don't have so much space here. And here the invention of wheel. Okay, so I'm going to discuss first the beginning of agriculture. Well, in this age, that means in Neolithic age, the human has started producing their food. Not just they were not depending only on hunting, but also they have started producing their own food. That is, they have started agriculture. Okay, also they have learned that they can store some grains such as wheat and rice. They can store it for a longer time. Okay, so this is how they learned to produce their food. One more thing, they had started domesticating animals. Some animals like goats, sheep, dogs. Okay, and some animals they used for transportation of people and heavy goods such as camel and horses. Also bullocks they use for agriculture. Okay, it helped them in agriculture. Now let's just discuss the invention of wheel. This discovery has given birth to another discovery. I'll tell you, the invention of wheel was done by cutting the logs into circular disc. It is believed that it has been done by cutting the logs in circular discs. Okay, now this discovery was very important for the human development, or you can say the development of human civilization. Why? Because this invention has made the transportation much easier and faster. People can move from one place to another in a very easy and a faster way. Okay, now why did I tell you that this invention gave birth to another invention? Well, the invention of wheel has given birth to the invention of potter's wheel. That means an art form, and that is known as pottery. Okay, the invention of wheel has given birth to pottery. Okay, by using the potter's wheel, the human have started making pots and pans to store their grains. Okay, grains, I have told you, wheat and rice. Okay, now let's move to the last stone age, that is the Chalcolithic age. Well, this is just the ending of stone age. I'll tell you here, as you can see, I've written it here, the copper stone age. the Chalcolithic age or the Copper Stone age. It starts from 4000 BC and it is ending on 2000 BC. Okay, now let's discuss. It is clear by its name, the Copper Stone Age, that both copper and stone were used in this age. Okay, so you can write down that the tools were made of both copper and stone. Now, if they are using copper, that means the introduction of metals has been done in this age. Okay, so the introduction of metals took place. Okay, now guys, if the tools are made of copper and stone, then obviously these tools were much lighter, and also they were much better than the earlier ones. So they were much lighter, the tools were much lighter, and better. Okay, here I am going to tell you one thing. I can rub it now. Okay, so let me just explain you this. This word means copper. Chalco means copper and lithos means stones. So you can easily get the content of this topic. Chalcolithos, that means copper and stones both together. Okay, now I'm going to tell you, in this age the human have also learned to make bronze. Okay, they have also learned to make bronze by mixing copper and tin together. Okay, so copper and tin. Now, since the human have started using metal here in this age, in Chalcolithic age, so you can say this was the ending of Stone Age. This was the ending of Stone Age and the beginning of beginning of Metal Age. Okay, in this way the Stone Age has ended and the Metal Age has started. Okay, so students, your chapter has ended here. Now in the next class I am going to start the second chapter of your SST book. So till then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.